How do you describe these wild horses?
They're just magnificent. Yeah. And they've been here for centuries. They used to roam all up and down the Outer Banks, but because of development, they've been pushed as far north now as they possibly can go. So they're safest here. We do have a problem with people feeding the horses in the summer, tourists who don't know any better. And it's really very, very bad for the horses. They get, a lot of them, they can get sick. Some of them have even died from eating things like apples and carrots. So that's a problem.
50 feet is pretty much the, is that the county ordinance away from these horses?
It is, yes, yeah. And that's out of respect for the horse, but just as importantly, for the person's protection too, because they are wild.
How many of these horses are in Currituck County, like this part of the Outer Banks?
Well, there's about 100 here, and then if you go further south to Shackelford Banks, which is off the coast of Beaufort, North Carolina, there's another strong strain of Spanish Mustang there. And they have about 100 from what I understand as well.
But these are in fact wild horses and not feral horses, right?
Absolutely.
Which is, there's a difference there.
There's a big difference, and the Corralla Wild Horse Fund actually had Dr. Gus Cuthran come to our beach to do DNA analysis and testing on our horses because there was some concern that perhaps they were feral. And he determined that not only are they the descendants of the Spanish Mustangs, but it's the strongest strain of Spanish Mustang left on the entire East Coast.
Really?
Yes. And one of the distinguishing factors of our horses is they have one less vertebrae.
Oh, come on.
Yeah, and which is a trait of the old Spanish horse.
No kidding.
Yeah, yeah. So they only stand about 14 hands, which with, if you're looking at a domesticated horse, they would consider that a pony.
Mm-hmm.
But ours are considered horses because of that characteristic of the one less vertebrae.
I think it's worth noting here, too, that there aren't that many places in the United States where you can actually still see wild horses. Because when I think wild horses, obviously I think of Arizona and Nevada, especially Nevada and Wyoming and Montana. But out here, there are very few places, especially to see horses on the beach. Is that right?
That's correct. There's some horses further north, Chincoteague Island and Assateague Island in Virginia and Maryland. But our herd here is strong, strain Spanish Mustang, roaming wild and free.
Pretty much any time of the year, you could be walking down the beach and see one of these magnificent creatures walking right along with you. But if you want to increase your chances of seeing these wild horses, you got to get back here in the dunes because this, of course, is their food supply. So it makes perfect sense.
From here, where we are situated, we're only about 6 miles from the Virginia state line.
No kidding. That's how far north we are?
We are.
We drove to where the road ends.
Correct.
And that's it.
That's right.
You have to be in a 4x4 vehicle to be where we are today, right?
That's right. You need a 4x4, but you also need to lower your tire pressure. And we are still on Highway 12. It's just not paved. There is also absolutely no business up here at all. There's no grocery stores, no 7-Elevens, nothing. It keeps that nice, unique feel and charm. The focus of our company, of course, is the horses and explaining to, educating people about the horses, but also about the beautiful natural history up here and the environment. There's so many marvelous things to see and learn about the Currituck Outer Banks, and in particular, this 11-mile stretch. The best place to learn about that is to take one of the tours and come up and have a trained guide tell you all about it and show you firsthand.
Firsthand.
Yeah.
That's perfect. Edna, thank you for this.
Okay.